In Unit 1, we introduced the concepts of projects, subjects, experiments, assessors, and resources. In this unit, we're going to talk about how those concepts are defined in the XNAT codebase, and how that code was designed for extensibility to allow XNAT to support many more types of data as well. Even though we're going to be diving into the code, you don't necessarily need to be a developer to follow along. We're just really focused on the logical relationships between these items in the data model. Let's dive in. Each of the core concepts for data organization in XNAT are defined in a series of XML schema design documents, or XSDs for short. I've got a code editor open here so that we can look at the core XNAT.xsd file. These core concepts are defined here, as well as a number of other data types that extend those concepts and are natively supported in XNAT. You can see right here at the top, we've got a project is defined as XNAT:project data. Here's an abbreviation of what that definition actually looks like in the XSD. Likewise, a subject is defined as XNAT:subject data, and a generic experiment is defined as XNAT:experimentData. As an example of how extensible these types are, we can see that the subject assessor data type is designed as an extension of an experiment. Any extension of a core data type inherits all of that parent data type's attributes and elements. For example, the concepts of an ID, a label, attached resources, and associations with a project are common to all experiments and are therefore inherited by all subject assessors. But these extended data types can be given new attributes that are unique to their context. So, a subject assessor gets a subject ID and the concept of age, as in how old the subject was at the time of the assessment. Neither of those would be relevant to a generic experiment definition, but they are relevant to a subject assessor. For a more detailed example, let's look at an MR session. XNAT MR session data is an extension of the generic XNAT image session data, which is an extension of the XNAT subject assessor, which is an extension of the XNAT experiment data type. This should make some sense. An MR session is a type of image session, and all image sessions are performed on subjects, which makes them subject assessors, and all subject assessors are, at their heart, experiments. Let's look at the attributes and elements of the XNAT image session data type. We've got several fields here that you'd expect to find, including scanner, operator, modality, and UID. And then critically, this data type includes the concept of a scan, which we'll talk about in a second. But since an MR session is a type of image session, the MR session data type extends the image session data type, and it inherits each of those elements. Then, a few additional MR-specific elements are added to the MR session definition, such as coil and field strength. Getting back to image scans, these are defined as their own data type as well. The generic image session data type has a generic image scan data type that's associated with it. Included in here are many attributes, including the idea of attached files, which are defined as a type of resource. Then, logically, the MR session has a defined MR scan data type that extends the image scan data type. And here, a long list of MR-specific scan attributes are defined to pull data in from DICOM definitions. All of these elements and attributes in every XSD are available to any instance of data of that type, but it's rare that any given experiment has a value for every single one of these fields. Additionally, not every defined element is exposed in the XNAT UI, in report pages or in search results. Some of these defined elements are vestigial, such as initials for XNAT subject data. It was part of the original data type definition and therefore was part of the original database structure. And so we maintain that field for compatibility's sake, but its use has been deprecated for a long time. XNAT's display documents for the UI will usually contain just a series of commonly used elements. If you're curious about the value of a field that isn't being displayed in the UI, then viewing the XML will always show you the canonical version of what's being stored. We can show you that with an MR session real quick. For example, a scan in this MR session only has a subset of the elements that we saw earlier. We can view the XML for this session to confirm the elements that have been stored. Here's that scan. Also, we can even view the DICOM headers to get a look at what the actual values were that were pulled in. We'll talk more about MR sessions, scans, and DICOM data in the next unit, which will talk all about image session importing, anonymization, and archiving.